guys, it's Melissa. In this video, we are going to get the brand new Epson F570 set up and ready to go. So it comes, I did a separate unboxing, but we are going to work on getting this thing all set up. So we're actually gonna start on the far side of the printer, the left side over here, and we're just gonna open up this, move over here a little bit. We're gonna open up this little door and take out the tape, okay? And there's a little piece of like cardboard protective shipping material in there. So we're gonna take that out and then we can close that back up. And we're gonna go then to opening up this top piece. So there's some tape here that we need to remove. Just wait for that piece a little bit. And this one. And then what we are going to do is remove all the tape that you see inside of here. Now, the most important thing in here, which you won't be able to see until you look down in, is there's an orange like key in there that we need to just turn quickly to the left and pop out. So just be careful, pop that out of there and remove that, okay? And then you can take that protective sheet off the control panel as well. Okay, and close that back up. So we're just working through getting all of the tape off of here. And next we wanna focus our attention on this back panel here. This is where your roll is going to go, okay? So as you know, this machine can handle rolls of paper. It includes the spindle roll that's needed and it actually includes the rolls as well. Okay, so we'll just open that up. And lots of tape and material inside of here as well. So we'll just go through and carefully remove all that tape. Okay. There's a piece in here. This is for the sheet feeder. So just make sure that you get all that. All right. Set that up shortly. Okay. And then you're gonna push it forward as, whoops. There's a piece here. Let's see if this, how this comes off. This has to come off. Let's see. Oh, you lift this blue, there's a blue handle here, and lift that back. And then the spindle feeder, as I said, is down inside here. It's this metal rod, and there's some cardboard and whatnot that we need to get out of there before we can completely set this up. This thing is packed very well, I will say that. Okay. And just be careful getting this all out of here. You want to do this unpacking in the location where you are going to keep your machine, okay? So this is where I'm going to be keeping my F570, so this is where I'm doing the unpacking. It would be easier to do it like on another table, but you just want, because it's still, you want to move it when it has those protective pieces in there, it's a good idea to do this in the location where you want to keep it. Okay, so we have now all of the packing material out, and now we can go ahead and focus on filling the ink, which is going to be right here in this ink tank. Now, all of the ink, as you know, the ink all comes with the machine, okay? Not only these four 140 milliliter inks, but also a second whole set. So you get 280 milliliters of each color for the ink. And what you're gonna do is shake each of the inks for about 15 seconds before you put them into the machine, okay? And they're all gonna go right in here. These are genuine Epson inks. This ink, or this printer, this sublimation printer takes the T49M4 CMYK inks, okay? So we're gonna do all of that. I'm gonna grab a pair of scissors here and we'll take them out of the vacuum seal bags as, you know, when we're ready to put them into the tank. So we're gonna open that up and then inside are where all of the inks go. And we need to lift up the blue piece for each one before we can pour the ink in. So take the ink out of the cart, out of the bag, okay? And it has a cap on it. So you need to remove the cap, okay? And then carefully place it into the carriage. Now, this only fits in one direction on here. So if it's not fitting, don't shove it in there. Just turn it 180 degrees. Now, if you listen closely, you can hear the ink filling the tank. What we want to do is be watching this tank down here. We only want the ink to go to the top line. And when it does, we're going to stop the ink from filling, okay? It's not going to take this whole cartridge, but we can save the rest of this cartridge for later, all right? So while that's going, I'll take the rest of the inks out of their bags. Just keep an eye on it. All right, and then we'll stop that. And again, we can place the cap right back on and then proceed with the other colors. Make sure you put the blue cap down and then go to the next color. And make sure that you're putting the correct color in the correct tank. So this is the pink or magenta. Okay, and this same thing, we'll wait until this fills up and then we'll go to the next colors. We'll put the final blue ink in. It's important, just as a little FYI, not to squeeze the ink. Once the blue is done, you are complete. So just obviously take that back out of the ink tank there and make sure that the blue tab is down, and then you can close this up. You are going to have extra ink in all of the cartridges, so save them. Just make sure that the ink caps are on really tight so that you can reuse them. Now, at this point, your ink is in the machine, but it's not fed into the line. So you now need to go over and work on that control panel, which is going to pull the ink into the lines. That's a process that takes a little bit over an hour. Once you have your printer connected to the power source, now you are going to work on this control panel to turn on the printer and finish the setup of the actual printer. So this panel actually flips up. So I'm gonna flip it up so it's easier for you to see. Hopefully we can avoid somewhat of a reflection here. Okay, and then the power button is just this small slender button. You're just gonna press it and you'll see the screen pop on, and then you're gonna follow the directions from the screen. So the screen itself is a touch screen. Okay, so we have already filled the tanks, and this is telling us, you know, how to fill the tanks. Once we have finished filling the tanks, we want to click proceed, which we have already done. Now we're going to click start. So this tells me it's going to take 75 minutes to complete the initialization, which is, and actually it's giving a countdown, as you can see there. This is pulling the ink from the tanks that we just filled into the lines. So I will meet you back here when this is done, because we are certainly not going to sit here for 75 minutes. Once the initialization is done, the control panel will go blank. If you press just this button here, the power button, it'll bring you to this next screen, which is telling you about loading the paper. So we're just gonna follow through these prompts together and see what happens. Okay, so I picked load paper, and then it's asking me, do I want the roll of paper is not loaded, that I can use the auto sheet feeder, or I can use cut sheets. So let's just try with roll of paper. So now it's giving me the directions on how to do that. So open the cut sheet cover and the roll paper cover. All right, so as you know, the machine comes with three rolls of paper, 24 inch wide and 2 17-inch wide. So we are gonna just, we'll start with the 24 inch wide and see what happens. So we have to open this paper cover here, okay? And open the cut sheet cover and the roll paper cover. Open. What's this? Okay. It must sense that I've done that, because now it's gone to the next prompt, which is telling me to load the roll paper. Now, this is the first time that we've done this, and I have no idea how to do that, so I'm going to click see guide, and it will guide me through. Remove the transparent flange from the spindle. Okay, so we need to lift this thing out. Okay, the whole roll spindle lifts out. Remove the transparent side from the spindle. Okay. Place the roll paper as shown and insert the spindle. Okay. So you want it like most people like their toilet paper. Oh, that's the wrong one. You want the part of the roll, the end of the, wow, the roll is heavy, so just be careful. You want the end coming over. A little piece of tape on there, whoops. Okay, so we've got that. Next, insert the roll paper into, so there's no gap. Oh, okay, so we wanna make sure, let's see, hopefully you can see what I'm doing. So we wanna make sure that there's no, this gap, we don't want that. We want that whole piece to go in there so it's taut like that, okay? All right. And then attach the transparent one back to the spindle and push it so it starts. Okay, so, and we want this, we want it to go this way, okay? And the roll comes out the end, okay? And then, oh, we wanna make sure there's no gap here either, so we need to push that whole thing in there. You really need like a third hand to do this. Okay, so we're good like that. And then set the roll spindle on the right back into the spindle holder. So we're gonna do the right side first, okay? Insert the edge of the paper into the, oh, I'm gonna put that. Okay, insert the edge of the paper into the slot until the sound beeps. Close the roll paper cover and the sheet feeder. Okay, that's this two-part piece. All right, and it already sensed that I am using general purpose textile paper. That's what came with the machine. Well, that was super easy, and the on-screen directions are very easy to follow, as you saw. This literally was the first time that I've done this as well. Now it's loading that paper for us, so we'll see what the next prompt is. Okay. So that's all ready to go. Now we can go back into the menu and see if we can set up the Wi-Fi. I just went to settings and I'm gonna scroll down. Usually in general settings, there's probably a what network settings connection, and we will go through that. To download and install the utility, the driver, to run the F570, you can do that all online. So you'll go to epson.com/support/F570. So when you go to that page, the software is again compatible with Mac or PC. So this is a smart page. It knows what operating system you're on, or at least it detects which one it thinks you're on. So if it's incorrect, you can obviously pick something else. But what you wanna do, expand the drivers and expand the firmware. You're just gonna download, they'll download onto your computer. You will only have the Epson Edge print if you got the professional version of the 570. So I'm not even gonna get into that right now because that is different than the basic package. Okay, and then we will also download the firmware. All right, so they will all end up in your downloads. Let's just kind of go through and see here what happens. Usually these installers are pretty straightforward and will, you know, walk you through with on prompts or on-screen prompts. This is just telling me it's downloaded from the internet. Am I sure that it's safe to open? Yes, I want to open it and move forward. This is asking me for my computer's password. So your admin password, that's what you want to put in there. Okay, we have already charged the ink. That was that 75-minute process. So if you are doing this while you are charging the ink, then you're gonna have to wait, looks like. But we've already done that, so we'll click continue. We have already set up the wireless connection, but I'm going to add the printer to my existing network. The printer is already on our wireless network because I went through the setup on the control panel of the printer itself. Confirms that it was found. It will only be found if the printer is still on, so just make sure that the printer is on. You need to add the print queue to the printer list. Click add printer. to open, and then follow the steps. Select Epson and click Add. Pretty easy to do. It's telling me to pick the TCP/IP, so that's why I'm picking that one. Okay, and then I'm gonna click Add, and we'll click Continue. Epson's Express product registration. Do you wanna register? I'm gonna click, well, you wanna click yes, obviously, but I'm gonna click no for right now for the purposes of this video. Okay, and the software and installation, the printer installation and setup are complete, so we'll close that out. Then we'll go to this next one that we downloaded. Let's see what that one is. Looks like the drivers, which I think was installed at the same time, but we'll go through that just to verify. The package will run to determine if it can be installed. Again, asking me for my computer's password. You can keep or move to trash, whichever you prefer. And then the final thing that downloaded, we will do that with the firmware. Okay, so you'll want to follow through all of these steps. It's obviously just taking you through the firmware update. I'm not going to do it right now because I'm not directly next to the printer, but you would continue to go through and then the installation would be complete, okay? So you can confirm that by going into your system preferences, and if you go into printers and scanners, your F500 should now be listed. So you can see I actually have a couple of Epson sublimation printers, but here is the F500 and it is installed and ready to go. It is all right, so we have the ink in the machine, we have the Wi-Fi set up, we have the paper, first roll of paper all set up and ready to go. The software is on the computer and we are now ready to make our first print on the Epson F570. So I have to say that the setup process for this is very easy to follow. You get this sheet here that tells you exactly what to do step by step for the parts, like unpacking, removing the packing tape and adding the ink, and then everything else as far as firmware, Wi-Fi, and the loading the paper, it's all on this little control panel, and the directions are very, very easy to follow and intuitive, so you should have no problem doing that. If you have another Epson sublimation printer, the 170, which you can see I have here, it'll run off the same software, so you won't even need to reinstall, but if you need to install the software, I obviously showed you how to do that as well, so you are all set to go. The great thing about this Epson F570 sublimation printer is you can print, if you're coming like I am from the crafting side and using Silhouette Studio as my preferred software, you can print directly from Silhouette Studio back both on a Mac and a PC. So I can't wait to see what we end up printing with this and how it changes how I do sublimation. And of course, I'll have lots of tutorials, blog posts, videos on YouTube, and additional information throughout to answer questions, tutorials, projects, and anything else we can think of.